Welcome back. In the previous video, we have seen how to record and play back a simple script. Now I will give you insights on two main things, which is like console and results. Console is the place where Oats pushes a log into the this blank screen, where you can see what is exactly happening at each step. Okay, it will help you to debug whenever required. And then the next tab is results. This is the place where we can see whether each step has passed, how much time is taken in total. What's the timestamp? Let's expand this and see what more we can see. It says script, first script. And then we have the sections like, you know, initialize first script, run first script, iteration one. In case you are running for multiple iterations, you would see one more iteration, you know, here that we will explain later. And then we have finish first script and then end script. Okay, so let's expand each of them. Launch browser. It says it has launched Internet Explorer 11.472 version and it is passed successfully. Now we can expand the iteration. If you see here, there is something called think. I'll tell what think is in the later sections. Now we have, if you see here, the same sections that we see on top is what we see here. No title, testingtools.co, testingtools.co. So it will check inside what is done. It is navigating, so this has passed. Similarly, again, think has come. It's basically a wait period. Think is like, you know, when we are actually recording the script, you might have some delays. Like, for example, you wait for the page to load. And even after the page is loaded, you might be thinking what I should type and all those things. So that's all a gap that you have when you're interacting with the browser applications. So this OpenScript tool basically also captures that wait time and puts it in the form of think. We can remove the thing when it's actually coming back to playback so that you will not have additional delays. And then the next one is testing tools, the second part of what we see here. You can expand it and see. So it's waiting for the page, you're entering the value, and then again thinking and then pressing enter. Okay. And then finally, you wait for the page and click for the link. And then in the last section, you wait for it and close the browser. So this is how the results look in this particular tab. Now there is another view here, something called details. So this entire results can also be viewed in form of a HTML view, and which is shown in your details tab. You can click on double click on details tab. So it expands. You can again double click to restore to the original size. So in details, if you see here, this is somewhat same as what we have seen in the earlier tab, but this is more in a more, you know, understandable and, you know, HTML format, which is more user understandable. So here it says total iterations are one, and then total steps performed is four, because we have four steps here, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then it says total script actions are six and total pass is six. So every interaction, everything that, you know, you have done is getting captured here. It says whether it's passed or failed. So it's a HTML view of what we have seen earlier. Cool. Now, let's understand a little more about the console. I'll just do one thing. I'll skip everything. Skip. Skip. And now let's go into the run section, the Java code. So in the run section, if I say system dot Check me in. So generally when we execute any scripts and you want to debug, we keep these kind of statements wherever required. For now, I have skipped all the steps and only one particular statement is available, which will get executed when I play back. If you see here, everything is put under if false. By default, it means whatever is present inside it will not be getting executed. And we have only system.out.println. This is like a normal Java. If you write your Java programs, you write these statements to see if, you know, a particular statement has been reached, and then you can debug by outputting some values. So that's all pushed into the console, whatever you see here. Now let's play back and see what happens. Go to console tab and watch carefully. The browser gets launched, and then it has not closed the browser because we have made it skipped during this. And then if you see here, this is what it is getting printed. Check me in console tab during playback of script. It is exactly what we have given here in the top. System.out.println. Okay. So if you want to make sure that, you know, the first step has been executed properly, then you can put this statement just after the finish of it. So you will know in console debugging. And you can also put some variables if you want to see. Those can also be pushed out to the console. And remember that the console gets flushed out every time a new run is, or a new execution is done on the script. Also, when you close the OpenScript IDE and open the OpenScript IDE, you will not have the console contents in the console. Okay. And there is one more other thing which I want you guys to know. And again, unskipping it. You see here, whenever there is a wait for page, you can also see that OATS will actually capture the screenshot of the web page. There are other tabs, we will look at them later. I hope we have a fair understanding of console and results file now. And then if you again execute this, multiple results file will get generated. I think I can show you here. The first one was what we have done earlier, and then we skipped all statements and gave only the system.out.println, and that is the second result. Okay. And if you see here, it has executed only for 2.497 seconds. Because we have commented everything kind indirectly, and then, you know, we executed only for printing the output in the console. So in the next video, I will explain you about some of the record and playback settings. Thank you so much for watching this video.